بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا صدق الله العظيم. My respected brothers and elders and sisters listening from home, as far as the Ummah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned, the most important two things in the life of a believer is Allah and His Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everything in our lives, as far as a true believer is concerned, it revolves and it rotates around the sayings of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No doubt, dear brothers, I'm sure you're aware, it's the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, where fortunately and unfortunately, I say this, that whilst I don't discourage any member of the Ummah to take advantage of this month of Rabi'ul Awwal as an excuse to revive his iman, to revive his love for Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, as I mentioned in last week's reminder, it also saddens me to mention that why should our love for Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be restricted to the month of Rabi'ul Awwal? Why? You need to ask yourself, I need to ask myself, where was that love for our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prior to Rabi'ul Awwal? Whatever people are doing, whether it's a right or wrong, in the name of the love of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, question is, where has that love gone for the last 10 or 11 months? Where? I want to take the opportunity today, brothers, to discuss with you the importance of following our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a role model. You know, it's sad that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, despite He saying to you and I, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا, for you, Allah addresses you and I, for you, O Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lies in the Messenger of Allah uswatun hasana, a very beautiful, a very perfect example and role model. Yet despite it's sad, majority of us, if we look into our lives, where is the love of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives? It's important, dear brothers, we realize at this emotional time, we realize that our deen is not based on emotions. You want to understand this? Our deen is not based on emotions, whims and desires, but our deen is based upon the true authentic teachings of the Quran and the Sunnah lifestyle of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's no two ways about it. I make a reference to Surah Al-Fatiha, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions you and I every single day. Every single day, we recite Surah Al-Fatiha in every rak'ah of every salah. Every rak'ah of every salah. And we make a specific dua, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. But oh Allah, guide us. Guide us on the Surat al-Mustaqim, the straight path. The path that leads to eternal success of the hereafter. That's what we mean when we say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh Allah, please guide us. Or a better way of putting it, Mufti ibn Adam, Hafidahullah, mentioned this point. That to ask Allah and to translate اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ as, oh Allah, guide us on the straight path. It's possible that you are guided, you're signposted, and you're shown this way, Norman, is to Brahman Lane. Although I'm sure he knows it by now. But there's a possibility that he's put the address on the sat-nav, even sat-navs could go wrong as well. I remember reading in one newspaper some time ago, this person was adamant. He's gonna follow his sat-nav. There's no two ways about it. This is the thing of the 21st century. He followed it. He was going through countryside. You won't believe, of course, sometimes sat-nav or all sat-nav didn't update him. So this part of the land, the countryside, it wasn't updated. But he was so adamant that this thing is gonna take me to my destination, he almost went over the cliff. Wallahi, this was a story in a newspaper some time ago. He had to get the recovery guys to pull him back up again. So sometimes you say, guide me. Someone can give you the guidance, signpost you, show you the direction. Even then you can get lost. You can get lost. So here, Mufti ibn Adam Hafidahullah, he translates, oh Allah, just put us on the right path. Allahu Akbar. Not just guide us with the knowledge, correct knowledge and understanding of deen, just put us on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. Because, oh Allah, I fear that you've given me the guidance in the form of the Quran and the Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But even then, if I'm not steadfast on my deen and strong on my deen, there's a chance I may go astray. So Allah, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ al-Mustaqim, just put me on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And that Sirat al-Mustaqim, it leads a believer to the ultimate success of the hereafter, Jannatul Firdaus, paradise. That's what Sirat al-Mustaqim is meant to do to you and I. It's meant to lead us to the ultimate success of reaching our ultimate, our final destination, Jannah and paradise. That's the ultimate success. But to remain on اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, to remain on Sirat al-Mustaqim, is important that we equip ourselves with tools, with means to be able to remain steadfast on Sirat al-Mustaqim and to reach our final destination, Jannatul Firdaus. For this is imperative, brothers, that we follow Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the way Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have commanded us to do so. And that leads to ultimate success. وَمَنْ يُتِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. One who is obedient to Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would achieve ultimate success. فَوْضًا عَظِيمًا. Ultimate success. So for you and I to always remain on Sirat al-Mustaqim, we have to make sure we have the obedience of Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives. Any kind of deviance, any kind of deviance and detour from the Sirat al-Mustaqim, from following the authentic teachings of Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will lead us astray like that sat-nav. It will take us over the cliff and into where? The fire of hell. And the problem now, coming back to Rabiul Awwal, the problem is, alhamdulillah, it's good. I tend to say, you know what? Don't pick on people. You know, we've got... Where do you get the time to point fingers at others? Where you get an opportunity, okay, rectify yourself. But you know what? If Rabi'ul Awwal, for example, if Rabi'ul Awwal is the only time and the only excuse for someone to, I don't know, wear the green pagri, let him wear it. Just let him wear it. If Rabi'ul Awwal is the only excuse for him to attend a seerah conference, let him. But my point here is, dear brothers, is for us to realize the bigger picture. The bigger picture. I'm not saying don't have seerah conferences. This is a seerah program. We're talking about the life of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which I said to you is actually a practical demonstration of the Quran. The Quran is the theory, and the practice behind the theory is Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when we talk about obedience to Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell me, brothers, logically speaking, how can one be obedient to another if you're doing completely contrary to whatever that person has commanded you to do? If I claim to love someone, if you claim to love someone, then I'm sure any person with a bit of logic will summarize or come to the conclusion that, of course, the way he eats is the way I will eat. The way he thinks is the way I will think. The way he speaks is the way I will speak. If he did this, even if it is illogical, even if it's illogical, but it's proven by the teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then I'm prepared to do so. That is called 100% ita'ah. An obedience to Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So whilst we express our love, it's important, dear brother, that we realize some fundamental principles in our deen. That we can only be sincere and genuine in our love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if you are actually practicing upon his true teachings. So let us understand. Let us understand what is the purpose of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being sent to this world, to mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, لَقَدَ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا, that indeed for you, O people, lies a beautiful example and role model in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know how sad it is, dear brothers? It's so sad that we've got this perfect human being in front of us. A perfect role model. Yet look in today's day and age who we are following, what we are following. A perfect role model. Yet you want to assess, I want to assess how much of a role model is the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Take a look at yourself in the mirror. Take a look at yourself in the mirror and remember when we talk about the role model, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the role model, we're talking about externally and internally. We're talking about externally and internally. To the extent that, dear brothers, if we're looking in the mirror, we should see a spitting image of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our appearance. When we look into the mirror, the internal spiritual mirror, our characteristics, what we harbor in our hearts, should reflect the pure heart of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's what it means by Uswatun Hasana. He's a role model for us externally and internally. Then Allah continues to say, for who? He says, لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهُ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ, that he, alayhi salam, is a role model for those individuals who have a hope and firm belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ, and on the day of Qiyamah. These are the true criteria. that if a person has firm belief in Allah, he has firm belief on the day of Qiyamah, and he believes that following the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in all aspects of his life, he will be rewarded, then these are the individuals for whom the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is truly a role model and example. So what does that mean? What does this verse mean? This verse means that in order we follow the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the hope of what? Getting reward. Allah will reward us in the hereafter. This is why these two conditions are attached. لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. That you believe in Allah, you have a hope. Ruju, raja means a hope. You have hope in Allah. What kind of hope? That on the day of Qiyamah, Allah will reward you for following the life of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that brings me to a pertinent point, which is, how can something be worthy of reward which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not even command us to do? Our deen is very simple. We people make it complicated. That's how simple our deen is. How can something, in order for a deed, an action, to be worthy of merit and reward in our Sharia, it must be in accordance to the teaching of the Quran, authentic teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only then that act or action will be worthy of reward. And only then, by doing these kind of actions, one can actually say, I am a true ashik, a soul lover of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What kind of a role model are we talking about, dear brothers? What kind of a role model are we talking about? We are talking about a perfect role model in every sense of the word. Every sense of the word. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a perfect role model when it came to ibadat, acts of worship. Therefore, you and I, the Ummah Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we claim to be true lovers of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we have no choice other than to aspire to be perfect in our ibadat and worship. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a perfect role model in muamalat, transaction, business transaction, dealing, buying and selling. Likewise, there's no choice for you and I. Should we claim to have the love, sincere and genuine love for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have no other choice other to aspire to be perfect in our mu'amalat and business transactions. I'm defining to you and myself the meaning of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being a role model. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a perfect role model in adab and mu'ashara. When we're talking about social interactions, whether be it with his own wife, his family, his friends, his neighbors, Muslims and non-Muslims alike, his associates, even his enemy, Allahu Akbar, even his enemy, our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a perfect role model of compassion and mercy. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, as a mercy to mankind. Not as a mercy to the Muslim Ummah, but as a mercy to mankind. Muslims, non-Muslims, animals, you name it, plants, everything. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a mercy to the mankind, to everyone. Alameen, to all the worlds. So whether it was with his wife, whether with his family, whether with his associate, Muslims or non-Muslims, he alayhi salatu was salam was a perfect role model. Therefore, for you and I to be sincere in our claims of loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have to judge by looking at our social interactions with our wives, with our family, with our siblings, extended family, relatives, neighbors, all associates, all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's okay for us just to turn around and yes, just openly declare, empty from the inside, and just declare, we love the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we're ashika rasul. That's not the way to prove your love for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the aspects of your life and my life which we have to really reflect on. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the perfect role model when he came to husni akhlaq, character, personality, mannerism. I ask myself the question and I ask you brothers listening, where is that character, prophetic character of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives today? And then we have the cheek, we have the audacity to say, I am Ashika Rasul, I love Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Come on. You know and I know that person is fake. He's not genuine. He's not sincere in his love for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like a poet said, لَوْ كَانَ حُبُّكَ صَادِكًا لَأَطَعْتَهُ فَإِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَا يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. That if a person is honest and sincere in his love for someone, then you will see that person is always obedient towards his beloved. Always. That's logical, it's common sense. When a person loves someone, that's it, he's ready to listen. What is it? Oh, Messenger of Allah, you want me to do? You want me to what? You want me to display character? I will display character, sublime character. I'm ready to do that. You want me to concentrate and bring about devotion in my ibadat? I'm ready to do that. You want me to be honest and truthful in my muamalat and transactions? And I'm not a benefit fraudster? I'll stop doing benefit fraud. I'll do that. That's called Ashika Rasul. You want me to treat my wife properly and my family and all the creation of Allah? I'm ready to do that. You want me to be merciful to my young one and respectful to my elders? I'm ready to do that. That is what you call Ashika Rasul. That is what you call a true lover of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brother, let us bear this in mind. When we talk about the love of Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this can only be proven when we look into the spiritual mirror. When we look into the spiritual mirror and we then assess ourselves according to these four criteria. In aspects of ibadat, in muamalat, in muashara, and in akhlaq. If our life is according to the teachings of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in these four areas of our lives, only then you and I can truly claim to be the lover and follower of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So to conclude, dear brothers, the seerah, it's a long topic. And I said last week as well, that any aspect of deen which we touch upon or we discuss, in reality, is discussing the seerah and life of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Pick up any verse of the Holy Quran. Who was the practical demonstrator and force behind it? It was none other than Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If it was a do, a command for us to carry out, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was that perfect example. If it was a prohibition, something that we ought to stay away from, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through speech and action, he demonstrated that command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. And what we need to remember, apart from the things, the criteria I've already mentioned, the requirements for us to qualify for being the beloved of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lovers of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is pretty simple. What does Allah say? مَا آتَاكُمُ الرُّسُولُ فَخُذُوا وَمَا نَهَاكُمُ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. It's very simple. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O people, whatever I have given to my Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to do, just do it. Whatever he said, whatever he did, just do it. Don't need to add to it. Don't need to decrease from it. Just do it. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. And whatever I have prohibited whatever the Rasul has prohibited from you, for you to do, then what? Stay away from it. Simple. We don't have to make it any more complicated. Our deen is complete. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared that today I have perfected for you your deen. Takmeel. Complete. What that means, it there's no room to add. And there's certainly no room to subtract or deduct anything. It's complete. It's complete. This is exactly what the Sahaba and the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demonstrated. That's what they demonstrated. Total submission to Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my request, dear brothers, my request is, yes, okay, it's a Rabi'ul Awwal. Let us all take the opportunity to once again attune our life to the life of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us start thinking about this great personality. What does it take for us to think about this great personality? Let us think about him. Let us increase our salat ala Nabi. Even if it's bare minimum, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us increase that. Let us pick up a book, at least in this holy, in this month of Rabi'ul Awwal, let's pick up a book of seerah and let's study the life of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you can't be bothered to pick up a seerah book, just pick up a simple sunnah book. And you know what to do? Every single day, just read one sunnah. That's all. Read one sunnah with a sincere intention of bringing this sunnah into your life. And you know what? That is the practical way to increase our love for Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, if we're doing things that are contrary to his lifestyle, then can you imagine on the day of Qiyamah? On the day of Qiyamah, many of us thinking, following our whims and desires, following our emotions, we start doing things which we think reflects our love for Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but on the day of Qiyamah, you know what? It's going to hold no weight whatsoever. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all true ashika Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all his love and the love for his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ameen. Wa akhir da'wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. La ilaha illallah.